Hello and welcome to Prudent Media News. Now a look at the top stories. A day and a half Ganesh idol immersed. Youth and old dance to the tunes of Ganpati Bappa Moriya. Sarvajanik Ganesh celebrations still on. Youth Congress NCP war continues. Sankalp Amonkar challenges NCP to win a single seat. Says alliance with NCP not required. Watch head on. Center determined to impose new mining policy. Mining companies to share 26% of annual profit with affected locals. Policy to have retrospective effect. Locals warn government on delay in the removal of River Princess. Members to move contempt proceedings against government. Agnel Fernandez says government not serious on the issue. And Zuze Philip doubts a senior politician behind Sankalp Amonkar's statements against NCP. Says may file misappropriation case against Youth Congress in Kankon Fund case. And now the news in detail. Sunday was the second day of Tsavat. People celebrate the festival with great fervor. The Lord of Wisdom and Prosperity is worshipped by Hindus and people of different religion participate. People worshipping the Ganesh idol for a day and a half was immersed on Sunday, chanting Ganpati Bappa Moriya Futcha Varshi Lokariya. But don't feel sad, still the celebrations of 5 and 11 days Sarvajanik Ganesh are on. Tsavat is celebrated with full enthusiasm since Saturday. Hindus brought the idol in their houses and worshipped Ganesh with different aartis. Various sweets like modak, laddu and nyuryo were prepared. Special prasad and food is prepared to mark the first day of the puja. Mostly, people worship the idol for a day and a half. And Hindus with special favors or Sarvajanik Ganesh festivals worship the Ganesh for 5 days or 11 days. The women are seen playing the fugdi. Sunday, the second day of Tsavat, is marked by the Navyanchi Puja. On Sunday, after the grand puja, the idol was taken for immersion. People worshipping the idol for a day and a half immersed the idol on Sunday. People were seen dancing and marrying to the tunes of Ganpati Bappa Moriya. Youth and the old participate in the procession of Ganesh immersion. They sing prayers and songs. The widely heard aarti is Ganpati Bappa Moriya Furchi Varshi Lokariya. Once again, after 5 and 11 days, people will gather once again for the immersion of the Ganesh idol. Each locality makes its own special pandal. These are known as the Sarvajanik Mandals. Different mandals display artistic and animated Ganesha idols depicting one story and myth of Lord Ganesha. Some mandals have it for 11 days, whereas some worship the idol for 21 days. People attribute social significance to the pandals as communities compete with each other to put up a more outstanding one. Bureau Report, Prudent Media. GPYC President Sankalp Amonkar has burst out at the NCP. He says NCP does not have any existence without the Congress and there is no need of any coalition. He has challenged NCP to win a single assembly seat on its own. Post Concord Relief Fund controversy, Sankalp Amonkar exclusively spoke in head-on with Pramod Acharya.
काणकोण फ्लडाच्या नावान एकठांय केल्लो पयसो तुवें खाला
कित्याक हांवें स्वता मरण पयलेलो मनीस ह्या काणकोणच्या नांवान हे पयशे गोळा करून हांव खावपी हेजेर म्हाका मात सुद्दां हो जो एलिगेशन आसा तेजेर हांव बिलकूल सहमत ना. संकल्प आमोणकर हो फस्ट मनीस आसलो आख्या काणकोणकारांक खबर आसा दोरी घेवन त्यो ते सायडीक गेलो ते सायडीचे नो लोक त्या घरान आसलेली बायलां भुरगीं तांकां हे वाटेक हाडून सोडले आमी तेज्या उपरांत परत लास्ट चान्स म्हणून आमी चॅक करपाक गेले.
एनसीपी म्हणटा की तुम्ही 75 लाख एकठांय केले आणि ते तुम्ही खाले आणि सध्याक तुम्ही म्हणतात की तुम्ही फक्त 18 लाख
10 लाख 38 लाखचे कलेक्शन आम्ही केला. एलिगेशन कोणी किरे करूंक शकता
बरं मागीर इतले दीस हो पयसो कित्याक पडून आहा काणकोणा खातीर केलें न्ही वर्स जावपा आयलें एक वर्स जावपा आयलें अजून तुमगेलो पयसो तो एकाउंटाकूच आहा कितें करप ताजे.
काँग्रेसीच्या कार्यकर्त्याक राष्ट्रवादी काँग्रेसी बरोबर अलायन्स नाका
डेफिनेटली
नाका
डेफिनेटली आमचे वयल्यान काँग्रेसीचे वर्कर्स ते आनी खूश जातले ते प्रमाणे जे लिडर्स आसात ते आनी ताकतले. हांव तुका एक चॅलेंज करून सांगता ही चॅलेंज हांवें पयलेली केल्या द राष्ट्रवादी कोयलिशन आमचे नासले कारणान हांव तुका सांगता आयज 22 ते 25 सीट आमचे काँग्रेसीचे बिंदास येता. आयज तूं चित काँग्रेस सायडीक दवर आनी एनसीपी घे एक सीट जिखूंक शकता ते हांव अजूनही तांकां चॅलेंज करता तांचे पार्टी अध्यक्षाकूय अजूनही चॅलेंज करता तो स्वता वास्को जिखूंक शकना. एज अ इंडिव्हिज्युअल आय कॅन से आय डोंट हॅव दॅट ऑथॉरिटी
इंडिव्हिज्युअल
माझे पर्सनल मत असा की आमकां अलायन्स
नाका
माझे पर्सनल मत आमच्या शिवाय ते कसे जिखूंक जाय एक सीट जिखून दाखव
ही
चॅलेंज.
ब्युरो रिपोर्ट प्रुडंट मीडिया.
The center is determined to implement the new mining policy despite a stiff opposition from the mining industry. The Union Minister for Mines, B.K. Handik, has made it clear that the benefits of the policy should apply not only to the new mines but also to the existing ones and those whose leases come up for renewal. The policy says the mining companies should share 26% of their net profit on an annual basis with the people affected by the project.
The new policy is intended to give those displaced by mining a share in the profits of the miners. The policy is a part of a legislation setting the rules for investment in mining. The draft of the Mines and Minerals Development and Regulation Bill 2010, being prepared under the supervision of a group of ministers, has endorsed a proposal stipulating that all resource operations of what is described as standalone companies share 26% of their net profit on an annual basis with the people affected by the project. The Union Minister for Mines says the bill, if approved by Parliament, could make it mandatory for companies to issue equity shares to each member of every family displaced by the project, as well as 26% of the profit, according to a draft version of the bill. The state governments are formally backing this proposal, and I will ensure that it is part of a new mining law. The minister said mines generated profits for their owners for decades, and those who had lost their land in the past should also benefit. Hence, the policy should apply not only to new mines but also to the existing ones and those whose leases come up for renewal. This provision could pose severe logistical challenge for companies as well as the government. The Union Minister for Mines says the benefits of the policy should apply not only to the new mines but also to the existing ones and those whose leases come up for renewal. This could happen if the local administration is able to identify those displaced due to the mines in the past. They will also have to offer one share to each individual from displaced families. The government's thinking is that If affected persons share profits arising from the mining operations, resistance from the local population whose land has to be acquired for industrial projects would dwindle. Mining companies such as NMDC and CESA Goa will have to follow the same principle while rewarding project-affected families with a share in profit and equity. The proposal has had a lukewarm reception from the mining companies. On this backdrop, it would be interesting to see how the government goes ahead with the policy. Bureau Report, Prudent Media.
It's time for a short break. Stay tuned.